This is a code walkthrough for the example file MathExamples.java. I'll assume you've downloaded this and have this in some local working directory, so let's open it up and take a look. This is a useful example file because it demonstrates, in order, code examples for all of the math capabilities that we discussed in a prior video lecture. Notice that all of these are pretty nicely commented, so it should be pretty easy to follow. As a reminder, the math class contains static methods and static constants, so every time we try to do something with it, it's always going to be prefaced by math.method, 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 or math.constant. And finally, notice that in all the printouts, we're incorporating both the input values and the result. So this is a good practice to get into as you're developing your own code. Make sure to echo out the data that you used and the resulting calculation. So for starters, I'm going to go ahead and compile this file, and I'm going to run it once, make sure everything's working fine, and a whole bunch of stuff goes blazing past. Now, for demonstration purposes, that really isn't the best way to do things. So we're going to instead run this with a debugger so we can step through the execution of this line by line. So we'll start by putting a breakpoint here on main, and we'll click the Run with Debug icon and get underway, and then we'll just start single stepping. So here are the values for pi and the natural log e. Absolute value of negative 15 should be 15, and it is. The natural log of e itself should be 1. So we'll start with some values where we know what the result should be, and we're good. And the base 10 log of 100 ought to be 2, and it is. Square root of 100 is 10. Let me scroll down here a little bit. Now we'll work with exponentiation. We'll use the pow method, so base and exponent. So this is taking 2 to the 8th power, which from a prior prerequisite class you might recognize as 256, which it is. Then the rounding, 12.8 will round up to 13, and 12.2 will round down to 12. Now notice that these are being printed out as decimal numbers, because we've assigned them to a floating point result variable and not an int, but these results are fine. Scroll down a little bit more. Now we're testing the maximum and minimum methods. So the max of these two numbers should be 67.2, and the minimum of these next two numbers should be 100. And notice that we're putting in two floating point numbers here, and we're putting in two integer values here, so we're demonstrating the overloading that's available. And that's 93. And so here's the implementation of finding the max or min of a number of values. First we'll do it in stages, so we'll set up the three values, and then we'll take the minimum of the first two numbers, which is 49, and then we'll compare that 49 to the third number, which is 48, and the overall result should be 48. And now we're doing the same thing, except all in one step. So notice that this expression here evaluates to one single int, same as up here, and we're substituting that for the first argument. The second argument, again, is that third number, and we should get the same result as before, and we do. So this example should show you how to go about using all of the methods of the math class that were discussed in the prior video lecture. Again, the key thing to note here is that math is a static class, and every time you try to use it, you have to call the method statically by prefacing it with the name of the class as opposed to the name of some specific object. So it's always going to be math.method, math.method, etc.